Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today we're diving into the magical world of stars and unlocking some hidden gems inside the star tool in Adobe Illustrator. And we'll start off with how to reset the star tool if you've changed it and you just want to get it back to normal. All right, let's get started. Okay, I'm here in Adobe Illustrator. I'm just going to go to File, New. We'll go to Print right up here, and then choose Letter and Create. So now we have just a blank canvas. I'm going to come over here to my Shape tool, and I'll choose Star right here. Now, first, if you're trying to reset your Star tool, really the only way to get it back to its original form is to restart Illustrator. But let's say you don't want to do that. Here are two ways to draw different kinds of stars that are similar to the default. Let's say your star looks something like this. Once you've changed how the star looks by hitting your up arrow and down arrow while dragging the star tool, you'll always have that shape, which can sometimes be a good thing, but you might want it back to the five stars. You can hit your down arrows to get there, but sometimes you aren't able to get it back exactly the way it was. So the way to fix this is to get on your star tool, click once on your canvas, and then choose a radius of 100 and 50 for the second radius, and then choose 5 points. We'll say okay. And this will put the normal type of star right back on your canvas. Now, if you want the kind with points that go straight across right here, the first step is to do what I just did by clicking on your canvas and changing it to 150 and 5. Then when you click and drag a star, you'll get this shape, which is not exactly what we want. Then hold Option on a Mac or Alt on a PC to get those straight. Now, if you want it to lock into place, you can hold Shift to get the exact star you started out with. If you want these two stars to behave normally, you'll have to restart Illustrator, unfortunately. Now, I want to just show you a lot of different ways you can use the star tool. First, you can click and drag, and then use your up and down arrows, I just mentioned this earlier, to increase the points on the star. While still dragging, hold Command or Control down to increase the length of your star points, or decrease. We want to go all the way down here. So now we have an easy starburst. Now, as I just showed you to reset, you can also, when you're on your star tool, just click on the canvas and say exactly how much you want that first radius to be. We'll put our first radius at 100 and the second radius at 200, and we'll put the points at 25. We'll say okay. And this is what we get. So you have even more control if you want to do it just by selecting the star tool and clicking on the canvas. Okay, now let's say we want to round our points on the star. I can do this by clicking A, which will get me to my direct selection tool right up here. And then, now this only works on, I believe, everything past CS6. Might work in CS6 too, but I'm not sure. But there are these little round corner widgets right here. You can click and drag these in. It will change all the selected corner points to rounded points, and you can just drag and make them bigger or smaller. If you're using something before CS6, you can go up to Effect, Stylize, and Round Corners right here, and then put in a radius. You can also hold Shift and use your arrow keys or the arrow keys by themselves to see how this is going to look. Of course, you're going to want preview checked. And this actually will put it in your appearance panel right over here. And by the way, all the panels you see here are under window. So your appearance is right here. Okay, I'm going to undo that. And we'll just use these corner widgets to change the appearance that way. Okay, now I'm going to draw another star. And I'll hold Command or Control to make those pieces really long. I'll just move it over here to the side. This time I want the outer points to be rounded, but the interior ones, these, not to be rounded. So to do this, I need to make sure these outer ones are selected and these inner ones are not. I'm going to hit A on my keyboard to get to my direct selection. You can see they're all blue. Every point is blue. So we want to make some of them white or deselect them. So I'm going to hold Shift with my direct selection tool. I'll get right here. I'll hold Shift and I'm just going to drag a box around those inner ones, and you can see they're white. Might be hard to see on your screen. All the ones that are in here are now white, and they don't have the corner widgets on them anymore. Now we can take that corner widget and just drag it in. So we get this effect. where these are still straight points and these are now rounded points. Now we can do the opposite by deselecting the whole thing, using our A tool, the direct selection, and drawing a box starting right about here so that we are selecting just the interior points. And you can see all these ones out here are white now or deselected, and these are selected, they're blue. So I'm gonna get on that corner widget now and just drag those out, and this is the result we get. Okay, now I wanna show you one more thing that you can do with corner widgets, it's pretty cool. I'm gonna get back on the star, and I'm gonna click and drag another star right here. I'm gonna go ahead and drag these widgets in. We'll go pretty small here. And then I'm gonna come up here and click on corners up here in the control panel. And by the way, if you're not seeing this far, that is under window control right here. We'll come in and click on the word corners, and I'm gonna change it to this third one, which is called a chamfer corner. And this basically makes it end up looking like a gear. So that's a really fast way that you can make a gear. And we can also hit L to get our circle tool. Find the center of this, hold Shift and Option, or Shift and Alt on a PC, and just drag it from the center. Select both with our selection tool, or hit V, and then select them both. And then go to Pathfinder and do the second shape mode, which is minus front. And here we have a gear. So those are just a few of the ways that you can use the star tool. It really is amazing and a huge time saver if you need to make shapes like this. All right, if you like this video and you want to see more videos like this, just hit the subscribe button and the little bell next to it, and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.